सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां भारतीकरुणापात्रं भारतीपदभूषणं भारतीपदमारूढं भारतीतीर्थमाश्रये। जस्ट वांटेड टू ऐड अ स्मॉल डिस्क्लेमर विच आई फॉरगॉट इन द लास्ट वीडियो ब्लॉग दैट आई हैड पुट। आई एम नॉट अ वेदांत टीचर, आई एम अ स्टूडेंट एंड वॉट एवर यू सी हियर आर माई पर्सनल म्यूजिंग्स एंड रिफ्लेक्शंस। And anything good that people see in this is the grace of my guru. Rest all is due to my ignorance. So with that disclaimer, I just wanted to start here on a topic that I was compelled to share when I was listening to a lecture of Swami Guru Parananda, and I would like to call it Shades of Devotion. Being a Vedanta student, our definition of devotion, bhakti, is given by Acharya in Viveka Chudamani, Swaswarupanusandhanam Bhaktiritya Bidhiyate. Abiding in one's own true nature as the self, the Atman, is the highest devotion. But en route to this Advaitic realization, to this highest form of bhakti, which is unchanging, unalterable, which is only one, Ekameva Advitiyam, as the Upanishad says, this highest devotion of being abiding in oneself has some stages before it, which comes under Saguna Bhakti. Saguna Bhakti is when you have devotion to God with forms. And that bhakti can have different shades. For example, Swami Paramarthananda defines bhakti as reverential love. And why reverential love? The qualifier reverence there is because God is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. It's like omni star dot star, as we say in our computer language. He is all that is good and great. And when you are in such an exalted presence, you are in awe. You are in complete awe of such a greatness. And reverence is a natural follow-up of that. I was recently listening to a lecture of Swami Guru Parananda, who also happens to be a disciple of Swami Paramarthananda, on Sadhana Panchakam. Sadhana Panchakam is another verse, five verses composed by Adi Shankaracharya, in which he lists out a series of sadhanas, a series of practices that a student has to do in his Vedantic path. And in one of those sadhanas, he said that it is important for us to develop devotion to God. And he says, Bhagavato Bhaktir Dhridhadiyatam. One must cultivate very firm devotion to God. And to illustrate this point, he shared a very small story which I felt that I should share here. It seems there was a group of people traveling in a boat after attending a marriage, a wedding party. So they were traveling in a boat, and this group of people also had a couple in it. The story goes that the husband was a jnani, a realized soul. And as they were crossing this river, they got caught in a thunderstorm which suddenly descended upon them, lashed them with rain and thunder and lightning. To make matters worse, the boat got caught in rapids. So everybody in the boat was holding on to their dear lives and screaming in fear, not knowing what's going to happen the next moment. It might capsize, the boat might capsize, and they might all sink and drown. So all sorts of fears are happening in their minds. Except this one person, the husband, sitting there calm and quiet. So somehow, by the grace of God, they managed to cross the river, and once they landed on the other side, on the shores, the wife asked him, how come you were so calm when all of us were screaming in fear? Weren't you afraid even in the least? So in response to her question, instead of giving her a verbal answer at that point in time, the realized soul suddenly pulled out a knife and held it at his wife's throat. It's like when you attack somebody, you're about to poke somebody with a knife, and he places the knife at her throat and looks at her and asks her a question. I have a knife at your throat. It's a dangerous implement. I'm having it at your throat. Why are you not screaming in fear now? So she said, but I know in whose hand the knife is. I trust you with my life, and why should I be afraid? Why should I be screaming now? Because I know who is the wielder of the knife. So the husband, the realized soul, he smiles and says, that is exactly the way with God. all the dangers that we see in our life, be it a thunderstorm, lightning, rapids, the tumultuous parts of our lives, difficulties, all the challenges that we face, that we consider inimical to us, that we consider dangerous to our happiness, are all wielded by God only, because He created this whole universe of living and unmoving things. Everything was created by Him. So when He is the wielder, where is a necessity for me to scream in fear? So what Swami Guru Parananda did by sharing this example was bring out to me, in my opinion, another shade of devotion. So earlier we saw reverential love because of God's sheer greatness. Here it's a trusting love. I can, like a baby gives itself very safely to its mother and hands over all the care of the baby, of itself, to the mother and say, you bring me up, I have no clue. In fact, it doesn't even know to say all that. It's just an instinctive, natural response to be with the mother and hope that everything is going to be fine. It's such unconditional surrender happening there. No intellectual gymnastics happening, no thoughts, no questions, no what if analysis and scenarios happening. It's just that my mother is going to take care of me. That trust is there. This jnani, this realized saint, in this story for me brought out that aspect of devotion. Trusting God, just letting it go and saying that, you know, I know you're there to take care of me. I don't know if there is going to be a thunderstorm in my life, but you are the wielder of that thunderstorm, and I am not going to be impacted in my real nature. So that aspect of devotion was brought out. And no wonder Acharya Bhagavatpada has said in his Sadhana Panchakam, Bhagavato Bhaktir Dridha Dhiyatam, develop, cultivate this kind of a devotion to God. And by such devotion, one sublimates one's own mind and makes it prepared for Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam, Vedanta Vichara. So devotion has many shades. Saguna devotion, the devotion to God with forms, has many shades. Devotion to the highest, the absolute truth, is also absolute. It's only one. It is ekam. There is no division in it, because there is no person who is a devotee. There is no devotion, and there is no person being devoted to. That triad has gone away. But to reach that, all these shades of devotion are of great use to us in our path. So that was a interesting snippet that I felt touched me somewhere deeply when I was listening to this lecture series by Swami Guru Parananda, and I felt compelled to share it. Hari Om.